Cuando me enamoro, doy toda mi vida a quien se enamora de mí. Y no existe nadie que pueda alejarme de lo que yo siento por ti. Dicen que no sabré.
I was teaching in Virginia, and we had a child, and I came back to Pittsburgh, and my wife was working, I wasn't. I took care of our daughter by myself. I don't want to say by myself. I was kind of like Mr. Mom for a couple of years, but then I said, I got to get a job. And I was supposed to get a teaching job at Duquesne. And when I called to ask them about this job, which was in June, they said, oh, we already hired somebody for that position, we couldn't find you. And I thought, well, it's time for me to change my career path. And I was familiar with cappuccino from going to Italy, from going to California and seeing the coffee scene in California at that time. This was in 1988. So I thought, I think the people in Pittsburgh would appreciate good espresso cappuccino, because it was just one of those things where I think a lot of things come to the United States because people travel. They have or enjoy something, and they either do themselves or find a way, or somebody said, let's do this in the United States. And so I said, I think I can sell, and I actually started selling coffee espresso machines in Pittsburgh, and the bar was actually a working show. The primary thing that I think that La Prima does, at the very base, is we're an Italian-style espresso bar. So we want our espresso and cappuccinos to be like those which you have traditionally found in Italy, which is really different than what you would might. If you go to five different coffee bars in Pittsburgh, an espresso and a cappuccino is going to look different. We want to do Italian-style espresso cappuccino. Single-shot, one-ounce espressos, cappuccinos. We have an 8-ounce, which has always been our base drink, but we do 6-ounce now, which is very much what you would find in Italy. So that's at the core of what we do, Italian-style espresso, and of course we do American coffee drink. We were the first cappuccino bar. A couple years after, the people that have Beehive opened Beehive, so they were right behind. When I opened up, I did not sell American coffee because I knew if I did, people wouldn't come just for cappuccino because they didn't know what it was. So it was a little bit of a fight to get established, being the first bar. Well, what's an espresso? What's a cappuccino? Giving somebody a one-ounce espresso and saying, wait a minute, you're making me pay a dollar for 1 ounce, like a half a cup or a third of a cup of coffee. So there was a learning curve. But I mean, America has learned a lot about a lot of different foods, right? When you talk about eating internationally, you go to any decent-sized city in America, and a trend that you're starting to see in Italy. So if you go even to the little town where my dad's family comes from, there are hamburger places, there are Chinese places, there are Turkish places, there are all kinds of different restaurants. But America's always been a treasure trove because of the immigrant populations in America.
It's just growing with the times. We've been pretty successful throughout the years, and especially of late. Keeping three stores adequately and properly staffed has been a challenge that I deal with on a constant basis. I mean, we have one core company, but three different very personality style stores where we're here is you're waited on from beginning to end. Somebody's making your drink, they're ringing you up. And whereas AC and CMU are different in that capacity, just even small things, how the registers are all slightly different from each other. Dealing with the extra layer of CMU dining, etc. Is something we don't deal with outside of CMU. So, one nice problem we're having is growth, managing growth and in capacity at our roaster in particular. And just keeping on top of, I say when my role as a manager, I focus on three things, which is beverage quality, customer service, clean and organized stores. Any message I'm delivering as director of retail is the focus is on those three areas. And any changes I make or improvements we try to make has to benefit not only the business and the customer, but also the employees as well. So those are my two triangles I talk about all the time. Hopefully I'm succeeding at them. So.
I don't know what's next. Just looking for maybe the next opportunity, if there is another opportunity. I think we always need to do well what we do, get better at what we do, so that's an ongoing challenge. So I think we'll just take the opportunities as they come. We just want to sell more good coffee to more people.